Hello everyone, and welcome back to Shelter 2. And it's that time again when you guys have been left to vote for our next heir because we just finished our litter with Via. And oh boy, was it a hard choice. The poll results were pretty diverse, and all the kittens this last time seemed to have so much personality. Personally, I don't even think I could have chosen if it was left up to me. But we had, this last time we had Dawn, the red kitten, Dusk, the dark kitten, Mocha, the brown kitten, and Misty, the white kitten. And you guys have voted, and the winner of the poll was Dusk. She is a pretty calm, but very motherly kitten who, even when she was young, was bringing back food for her siblings and making sure they were fed, and even trying to feed Via some of the time when Via didn't eat enough. So Dusk was very motherly kitten. And she was very attached to her sister Dawn, who is our red kitten, but Dusk is the one you wanted to see us continue with. So we will be following her this time, and let's go ahead and get started. And yes, we do want to start a new game with Dusk, and we can go ahead and skip the intro. We may go back probably the first time for each season, and each season will be about 20 episodes. We can vote on whether or not we want to start a new family or continue with this one. And because we are coming up on that, we'll probably have Dusk's litter and then her heir's litter, and then it'll be time to start a new season. So we'll vote on whether we want to start a new family or continue with this one, and we'll vote on, and for the beginning of each season we will show the intro again, just in case anyone is popping in new. So but for now, this time we will go ahead and skip the intro because we've seen it already, and let us start. Here we go. And I have my names up and ready to go, because here we have Dusk and her kittens. And there they are. This is just it's such a simple scene, but it's so beautiful, and I can't get over it. I just can't. And look at... And oh my goodness, we have, our red kitten is about as red as Dawn was. I've never seen that before. It looks like Via must have been carrying some really, really recessive really red coloring. Oh, I didn't realize that. Wow. Oh. That must be nice for Dusk because she was really close to her sister. So let's go and look through our kitten names. So I think we're going to call the dark kitten this time will be Adair. I hope I'm saying that right. That's a very pretty name. Somebody suggested that and I was surprised because that's actually, fun fact, name of one of my characters. And I did not think anybody else even knew that name existed, let alone used it. So it was kind of cool. So we have Adair, who is female, and let's see, and I should move the eminent temporarily, just I have to constantly keep organizing my name list, and I have to move names around a lot because sometimes you guys suggest duplicate names in Shelter 2 and Wolf Quest, and so if we have a wolf with the name in Wolf Quest or a kitten with the name in Shelter 2, I usually won't use it in the other series until time's gone on a little, so I have to constantly juggle names around. So let's see. So we have Adair. And I think we're going to have Luna. And that should also be on the reserve list. oh my goodness, I'm constantly juggling names. So let's see. And we have the red kitten and we have the brown kitten. I think we'll go with Pine for the brown kitten. And, oh, that's another name I should move. Oh, and here's a name that we can use. I'm still moving names around. Sorry, you guys. And let us name And this will, so we have all girls this time. We do have, I think Pine is actually a male. Usually, it's funny, the brown kitten is usually the one we end up saying is the male for some reason. I don't really know why. But we have Phoenix, our red kittens. Oh no, does it not fit? Is it not going to fit? Okay, so we're going to say her name is Phoenix, but we'll just call her Nyx, perhaps. And for short, Nyx or Nyxie. So we'll call her Nyx, but her name is Phoenix. And she will be our red kitten. I didn't realize there was a name on... some of these names may be too long then. But we'll make do. We'll figure out. So we have Adair, Phoenix, Luna, and Pine. And our mother is Dusk. And we'll go ahead here and set out into the winter. She ventures into the vast open world, a land full of prey to feed her starving family, who are not yet strong enough to leave their warmth and shelter. And here she goes. It's kind of interesting because of all the dark kittens that we've had, Dusk is the one who has been the most gray. Most of the others have been a really deep, chocolatey brown sort of color. In fact, even Via was. And Dusk is much more of this gray coloration. And let's see, there is a bunny over here. But yeah, Dusk is much more gray in coloration than any of the others have. But it kind of looked like, and we'll have to take a closer look, but it looked like Adair, our dark kitten, was a little bit more gray as well. And I wonder how much the colors are genetic versus... Oh, nice! Oh, nice! That bunny didn't even see us coming! I wonder how much the colors are inherited versus if they're just random, because I know we always have a red kitten, a dark kitten, a brown kitten, and a white kitten, but the actual coat patterning varies. So I wonder how much it was gray because Dusk here is gray versus if it was just random that we happened to get a very similar looking coat. So let's bring this bunny back up to our kittens. That was so fast. I can't believe she caught it before it could even run. Oh my goodness. Dusk, you truly are a good hunter. Dusk was, again, one of our very proficient hunters. And let's drop this for them. And it looks like it is the same coat. Adair has the same coat that Dusk has, I believe. So I wonder if it is genetic, because most of the other dark kittens we've had have been more brown, but Dusk is much more gray. It's kind of interesting. And she looks even grayer now because it's winter time, but even in the warmer months when their coat changes, because it does change a little bit. When we play as Kier, is it springtime already? Oh, I think it is springtime already. So you'll notice the change as her coat will shift, because if you remember when we played as Kier, in some of the seasons she looked very red and some of them she looked very brown, and that's the same. It's most noticeable with the red kitten, I think, but you can see, I think it's even perhaps a little darker now, but it tends to look a little lighter in the winter time, probably because the undercoat has grown in. And there is Bunnies. So let's go over here and we will hunt one of them. But yeah, you can, I think it's darkened up a little bit now. Dusk! Dusk! Oh my goodness, Dusk! Oh, honey, you just tend to have the food just like walk right into your jaws. We're gonna try and grab a bunny though, because this will feed all of our kittens and then we'll eat that. There we go. We will stop and use that to replenish our stamina on the way back. We'll drop our bunny and then eat this small vole creature. Oh, Dusk, you're funny. You're funny. Oh my goodness. And it was actually Dusk's sister Dawn who, I don't even know exactly what she did, but when they got cornered by the wolves last time, and there we go, we're gonna just chomp that right down whole, it seems like. But when we got cornered by the wolves last time, Dawn actually, that's Dusk's sister who's kind of spunky, a little bit sassy, just snatched a rabbit from somewhere on the ground, and because the wolves were right there, it pretty much looked like she had just snagged it right out of the jaws of one of the wolves from above. And that just, afterwards, I went back and watched that. I was kind of cracking up over it because, oh my goodness, first of all, it was such a Dawn thing to do. She did that kind of thing a lot. And secondly, it was just so, I don't even know how to describe it. But it seems like both Dawn and her sister Dusk, who we're playing as right now, are pretty good hunters. Dusk was the one who was always catching food and bringing it back for her siblings or her mom, and always letting everybody else eat first and everything. So she's a very caring, motherly sort of lynx. Much more so than her mother Via, who had more of a survival of the fittest mentality. My goodness gracious. Oh my goodness, Phoenix, you are so red. You are so red. I think you're even more red than Dawn was. They're just like getting more vibrant in color each time, but I'm pretty sure that Adair does have the same coat as her mom does. And then the white kitten and the brown kitten, their coats are pretty much the same. And that would be, let's see, can I remember all the names? That would be Luna and Pine. So Pine is our brown kitten, Luna is our white kitten. And let's go ahead, we'll get this bunny right here that has ventured a little too close to the den. And make sure. Let's get it. Okay, can we get it? Oh, it's gonna run. It's gonna run. Got it! There we go. Okay. Let's bring this back. This isn't too hard so far, but I want to knock on wood. knock on wood, because it'll probably get harder. It usually does. I think it's actually hardest when they're fully grown, because in this, if a kitten collapses, you can carry them. And so you can hunt down a deer and bring the kitten to the deer. But when they're an adult, when they're at least a young adult, because they're not adult until we start with them here, but when they're a young adult, you can't carry them. So it actually gets a lot harder the more it goes on, even though you'd think that it'd be easier because they'd be more able to take care of themselves. So we'll go ahead. And Dawn had a very sort of almost stern upbringing, in the fact that, like, even when that darkness showed up, her mom really didn't stop and sit with them. She just said, keep walking, kids, it'll be all right, sort of thing. And yes, we have collectibles. How many collectibles do we have? Let's just take a look. We have 16 deer heads, 3 bird heads, 103 rabbit heads, and we've gotten, is that a stone? And then a leaf. I don't know what all these are. We've gotten a couple feathers, a couple sticks. I don't know. Yeah, pretty cool. The collectibles are fun to try and snag those on the way. Goodness gracious, Phoenix. Goodness gracious, you have a very bright coat. Very, very bright coat. Oh my word. Yeah, I think she is even brighter red than Dawn was. I think Dawn was even a little bit more washed out. Oh my goodness, that's so awesome. And it does look like Adair has the same coat as her mom. You can see that at least the patterning is pretty much the same. So let's go up here. We'll stalk this bunny. And we started running a little bit early. Oh, it turns at the last possible second. There we go. And let's 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4. Okay, Pine, you are so hard to see. They're so teeny. Oh my goodness. I'm going to give it to you two first because, oh no, that was not what I meant to do. All right, it works, but I'll feed you guys next. And we're actually gonna start, I think Dusk would head more towards the south area. So if we look at our map, which a lot of you guys have said is memories, it would be the trees area. I think she would probably head more that way. Because they did get attacked by wolves 3 times this area, or in the winter area. And I think she would find it more sensible to try and avoid the wolves. I think Dawn probably wouldn't. Misty definitely would. Misty was our white kitten who was almost caught by one of the wolves one time. So I'm going to try and give it to you guys. Oh, nope. All right, we'll get you one. We'll get you one as well. Maybe we can get this vole thing. Got it. There we go. Perfect. Meal for one. There we go. And you have already eaten twice. Or, no, you've only eaten once. It's a deer who's eaten twice. So I want to give it to you. There you go. You can eat that. And we'll start heading down towards the forest area, the area with the three trees, which is over this way. And make sure. Looks like little pine is starting to get hungry. Oh, how many bunnies can we catch? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Dusk. That was awesome. One, two. We're going to head back up the hill. We'll probably eat some of these ourselves to help replenish. Two is here. Three is up there. Three is right here. Let's get the collectible. And there were even more. How many was that? That was six or seven bunnies that we just caught right in a row. There's one up here. We're going to eat this one ourselves because we want to replenish some of our stamina. And there we go. There's more. So that's four. Oops. And then you guys can have that one. Five. Six. Oops, no, I didn't want to eat it. I just want you guys to eat it. I think that was six. Is that another one? No, that's a live one, I think. Is that? Yeah, it's a live bunny. That was six bunnies. Six bunnies. Uh-oh. Everyone. Okay, wait. I can't see a thing when it's this dark, so we have all four. Alright, you guys, you just ate. There is a darkness rising. We're on our way to the tree area. Let's just sit and wait here. We'll lay down and the babies can lay down with us. And look at all the grasshoppers jumping. Oh, that's cool. Oh, that's cool. And we'll look at where is the darkness. Oh, it's okay, baby. It's okay, baby. Oh. Oh, Pine, it's okay. It's okay. Lay down, Pine. Lay down, Pine. You're okay, baby. Oh. Oh, poor Pine is freaking out. Oh. It's okay, Pine. Oh, no, I didn't want to grab you. I want to grab Pine. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Adair. Oh. I just want to grab. Can I turn a little bit? No, I have to get up. No, I just want to. No, Adair. I'm sorry, but I want to grab Pine. There we go. Now let's sit here. Hopefully that will kind of help him calm down. Pine is our male. And hopefully we can just get our. Oh my gosh. Is that gonna stop? Can we just lay down and be safe? If we stay right here, can we be safe? Is it retreating? I'm not sure if it's retreating or not. I think it's still coming. It's still coming. I think we're in the safe area, though. Are we gonna be okay? It's moving along the sides there. That's just a cloud. I think it's some sort of fog. I think it is some sort of fog. I'm pretty sure it is, because look at the way it's moving. It's some sort of very thick fog. It doesn't look like it's getting too close, though. Oh, there it goes. Okay. We can keep going. It's disappeared. See how fast it disappears? That's why I don't think it's a mudslide. That's why I think it's fog. Unfortunately, it seems to have spooked the prey. Alrighty. Well, let's just continue this way and, let's see if we can find anything to eat over here. We'll keep heading towards the trees. Oh, there's a collectible, though. We want to grab that. Always snag those when you have the chance. There's some prey up ahead. Some bunnies. And let's see if we can get one of these bunnies, because I'm sure our kittens are hungry after that long night. There's Luna. I was a little concerned for a sec, because Luna is... Luna was, like, right underneath. Okay. I don't see any others, though. There, one kitten. Adair is gonna get food. And who else is gonna get food? Looks like Luna's getting food, so we have to feed Pine and Phoenix now. Oh, let's get that collectible. Let's get the collectible. Oh, that's a vole. We won't bother with the vole because it's small. We'll go for that bunny that's hopping around in circles up there. Poor bunny is just like spazzing out in the corner. Oh my goodness. Pine? There you are. You're right. Just hiding in the grass. Okay. We'll go ahead and grab this bunny. That's kind of just running in circles. Can we stalk it? Oh. That poor bunny. I don't know what it was doing, but it looked like it may have suffered a head injury or something. Oop, what? Yeah, I know how I can eat myself, or I can eat for myself here. I know. Don't make me do it, though. So, Luna and Pine, we still gotta get something for Phoenix. And there's bunnies right there. What is that noise? Is that like insect noise or something? Oh, can we get it? Oh, we're going into the woods. Have we ever been in these woods? No. There's a bird. I hear a bird. Let's just head back out of the woods, you guys. Oh, and it looks like it's about time for us to wrap up. So I will see you guys next time. But until then, this is Jay, over and out. Probably didn't save that, but whatever.